In this video, I'm going to teach you how to enter scientific notation into your calculator so that your calculator interprets what you wanted correctly. So if you just type in this problem as written, 7.25, and then you can type in times 10 to the 14th, and then you can go divided by 6.022, times 10 to the 23. Now your calculator is not going to be able to interpret this correctly. You can see here that we end up with a 30 to the 37th exponent, which is if we had added these two exponents together, but we know that since we're trying to divide by, it should really be more like 14 minus 23. So we should end up with like a negative exponent, not a gigantic positive exponent. Your calculator wasn't able to interpret this correctly because your calculator is very literal about the order of operations. So first it multiplies the 7.25 times the 10 to the 14th. Then it takes that result and divides that by 6.022. And then it multiplies whatever that result was by 10 to the 23rd. Your calculator didn't know that the 6.022 times 10 to the 23rd was together in the denominator. So you can fix this by inserting parentheses around that answer. And then you can see that it does give a result that is more to the minus eighth exponent. But you can see here that it's kind of like maxing out the display. So this still isn't what I want. So I'm going to force my calculator into scientific notation mode by hitting mode first, then going down to the second row using the navigation key, scrolling over to where it says psi, hit enter, and that will put my calculator in scientific notation mode. Then I hit second, and then mode again, that quits it. You see that it says quit above the mode button. Now if I scroll up again, I can grab that calculation again, and then hit enter, and now it recalculates, and I can see all of the digits that I intended to have in there. And so that is equal to 1.2039 times 10 to the minus ninth power. An alternative is that you can use this nice fraction button. And you saw in the previous answer that your calculator has an E. We can actually use that E to type in our scientific notation from the beginning. That E is located here. It's two E's in a row. And so we're going to hit that. And that stands for 10 to the power of. And so I'm typing in E14 because the exponent was 14. I don't need to type in times 10. This tells my calculator that the exponent for the 6.022 is times 10 to the 23rd. Now I can hit enter, and you can see I get that same numerical value. So I recommend typing it as a two-line fraction so that you can see it, and using the E button to tell your calculator what is connected to what.